So this episode continues the series of 20 ways to unblock and heal the root chakra. Hey, Namaste, Goddess. It is Yogini Viv. I'm going back to using my full name instead of the nickname, so it's Vivine. I'll be sharing with you about how to work with crystals if you resonate with crystals for healing and strengthening the root chakra. My first favorite stone for working with the root chakra is smoky quartz. Because I'm not at my home, I don't actually have samples to hold up, but I'm gonna show you one on the screen very soon. I love smoky quartz. It's really one of the primary stones that I am just naturally drawn to. There's something about the richness of the color, which is sort of a grayish. It can go into brown. It's just something very mysterious about it, and I personally love smoky quartz. So here's the reason that I recommend it as a possibility. It's good for focusing you on the present moment. That is really important for the root chakra because you have to be here now. You have to really be present in your body to heal and to reap the benefits of this chakra. Nothing happens in terms of the root chakra when you're sort of out of your body, okay? And a lot of root chakra trauma can make us be literally partially out of our body. There are even psychological terms for this where you're like disassociated. So smoky quartz is said to help you focus on the present moment, increase your intuition about challenges and problems specifically and how to deal with them. So that is really crucial, how to deal with challenges and problems that you're having right at that moment, because that's what can bring up a lot of fear for us, and fear really negatively affects the root chakra. It also helps to dissolve emotional baggage. And again, that is stuff related to family, early upbringing, even karmic imprints. So that's really, really important. So I highly recommend that. If any of these stones you resonate with, then that is the right one for you. So, okay. For all the stones, as I continue on, what I most highly recommend is that you go to a shop if you can, like a metaphysical shop, and see and sense the stones. That's the best way. That is better than sort of just ordering them online. But if you're in an area where you can't do that, then of course ordering online is great. And I will have links below to Amazon where you can like easily order a particular crystal. My next favorite stone is hematite. Again, something I've always been drawn to. And I do have a weak root chakra. And as I said, watch the video on trauma and the root chakra. A lot of that, like a lot of you, I have dealt with those issues. So check out that video. But hematite, you can get it in its raw form and it looks very different than I like it in its polished form. And so there's this gleaming quality to it. And it has the sense of reflecting back negativity and pushing it out and away from you. I really find it a very grounding stone to hold. Hematite also helps with decision making and clarifying your thinking. I mean, when you see it, when you see that black silverish hematite, you can feel the power in it, or at least I can. And so it's this quality of focusing and sort of bringing all of your energies together. And so that's really helpful in terms of dealing with financial issues and just issues that have been troubling you that you don't feel strong enough to deal with. So hematite can be a perfect stone for you if it resonates for helping to heal root chakra issues. Another stone that we should talk about is red jasper. It is actually a beautiful stone. I personally have not worked with it, but I know that it is supposed to be very, very powerful. And that rich red connects with building your chi. Your chi is like your life force, what your spirit, what keeps the body alive, right? And it connects us to spirit. It's our own personal energy. It's called chi or prana. And so this stone, red jasper, would be a wonderful stone, again, if you resonate with it, for the root chakra, for adding to some dynamism, giving you sort of a little more will, but connecting in with that root through that deep red beautiful red color. Red jasper is mentioned in Viking and Germanic lore as well as ancient Egyptian. It is really revered the world over historically as just building courage, a stone for warriors. It may be a bright red, but it can also be a little bit more brownish red. Again, see what you resonate with in terms of jasper for the root chakra. Rejuvenating the libido and stimulating creative energy. So it's all about getting that energy, that the kundalini energy moving started. So red jasper is very powerful. Next is black tourmaline. Now that is a stone I've worked with and I love it. It is, as I said, I'll show a picture, will pop up soon, but I love the sort of, it just looks like this chunk of black rock, but you can really feel the power in it. It is a talisman of protection and a psychic shield against negativity of any form. So very, very protective stone, very shielding. It has industrial uses and uses going back centuries in terms of some of its abilities. But again, we're talking sort of on a metaphysical level. I just really resonate with it. When I hold it, I feel the grounding quality of it. There is a sense of really being protected, shielded, centered, not scattered, not lost in thought, not sort of wispy and woo-woo, but just very, very powerful, very strong. Neutralizing negative thoughts and internal conflicts. It's also said to help protect against the effects of radiation. Again, these are metaphysical properties. This does not mean you should put yourself in any sort of unsafe situations. By any means, you want to maintain your health, of course, at all times. That makes me think of tourmalated quartz. So sometimes the black tourmaline, you'll see like shards of it embedded in clear quartz, and it is beautiful. And it's said to be a beautiful balance of like a yin and a yang, that clear versus that dark sort of embedded through it. It's very, very beautiful. So you might want to also check that out, tourmalated quartz. Just as an overall balancer and a truly beautiful stone. All of the stones, before I continue on to the last few, all of these stones are fairly inexpensive. I wanted to concentrate on stones that were accessible, fairly easy to get, and not super pricey. Tiger's eye. I love tiger's eye, and I have a little story about it. I was actually at a business workshop, and a woman there came up to me and she said, you know, you need to wear some tiger's eye. I did not know this woman. And I said, well, why, whatever. And she said, well, it's going to really help you. And she said, it's going to help you be taken more seriously when you deal with the businessmen and try to rent space. They're going to think you're too spacey and, you know, just energetically, but tiger's eye will help sort of like just really focus you and bring your energy together and strengthen it. And that was really literally the first time I had thought about that or heard about tiger's eye. So it's a beautiful sort of brownish stone with this beautiful shimmer. I really like it because it is said to just give you the ability to focus your mind. And also it's said that the Egyptians used it for the eyes of some of the deities, some of the statues, because it represented divine vision. So again, if you resonate with it, if you can hold it in your hand or even look at it online, often if you're sensitive, you can tell if you resonate with it. But tiger's eye is also wonderful for the root chakra work. And I agree with the understanding that tiger's eye is good for the first, second, and third chakras. It definitely can resonate in any of those areas, because especially in terms of the third chakra, tapping into that confidence and will and clarity, the first, second, and third chakras, this stone can really, really be helpful. Try it, lay it on the body, and see, you know, what you notice. So this episode continues the series of 20 ways to unblock and heal the root chakra. And as I mentioned in that initial video, which the link will be below too, I will always state what are the stronger ways of healing the root chakra. And the strongest way is still working directly with meditation, using the mantra, the bija mantra for the root chakra. That is the most powerful way to heal the root chakra. These other ways are supplemental. This can be a very powerful way for those who are sensitive to crystals, though. So, you know, give this a try if you naturally resonate with stones.